Top historian hounded, that's the charge against the ruling dispensation. Romila Thapar, eminent historian and a known critic of the NDA government, has been asked to submit her CV to the JNU authorities. This comes as the university administration is apparently reviewing the post of Professor Emerita that Romila Thapar has been holding since 1993 and whether she should continue with that honor. The move has sparked a massive controversy over the current JNU administration and whether it's deliberately targeted a government critic.
26 years after the Jawaharlal Nehru University appointed her as the Professor Emerita, now JNU seems to be rethinking on whether Romila Thapar should continue in the post. JNU has asked renowned historian Romila Thapar to submit her CV so that the university can decide on her future as the Professor Emerita. This move by JNU has left many commentators puzzled.
The post of an emeritus professor is more an honor. It's not a job like a regular professor or assistant professor is. So I don't know on what basis this request has been sent. But certainly it does not have financial implications in the sense that those who are designated as emeritus professors don't generally draw a salary or any kind of remuneration. It's more an honor that has been bestowed for past services and recognition of their contribution.
The post of Professor Emerita at JNU is conferred after much internal recommendations and deliberations. And JNU's move to review that honour to Romila Thapar is being questioned, as the academic has been a fierce critic of government policies, especially on education.
Professor Romila Thapar is an internationally renowned historian. If it's a technical, procedural formality, surely the JNU administration has her CV. She has been teaching in JNU for the last four decades. But to ask for her CV seems to me to be an act of deliberately humiliating someone who has been a courageous critic of the central government on principle. I don't believe such measures do great justice to Jawaharlal Nehru University.
Romila Thapar was among the academics who raised her voice in support of the right to dissent. Questions are being asked on whether Romila's post of Professor Emerita at JNU is under threat because of her strong opinions. Bureau Report, Times Now.
And there has been a breaking development. JNU has clarified its stand and has rejected the hounding charge. JNU, in fact, has released a statement denying the charge that Romila Thapar is being hounded. The statement reads, "There is no move to discontinue their emeritus professor position if they reply to our letter and express their willingness to continue." Let's go across to Kangana now for more details. Kangana, what more does this statement released by JNU say? They are outrightly rejecting the hounding charge.
Well, exactly, Swati. The JNU administration has right now issued a statement where they have said that as per the ordinance and as per the Ministry of it is required for the university to write to all those who have attended the who have been an attendee at the age of 75. So she is definitely above the age of 75, which is why that letter has been issued to people. And she is not the only professor who has received this letter. There are more professors which the JNU administration is rightly saying in their statement that they have received this letter, and writing these letters is as per the ordinance is not for discontinuation but for an informed review by the Executive Council meeting, which was held in 2019 in the start of this year. So as per the ordinance, these emeritus professors, they enjoy certain things by the university, for example getting accommodation by the university, even though they are not paid extra salary,
right,
but they have been given accommodation.
So they have cited the ordinance, they've cited the procedure for the appointment or continuance of Professor Emeritus. Thank you very much, Kangana, for joining us with those details.
You're watching the NewsHour Special Edition, Debate Number 2, on Times Now, Super Prime Time.
Sudesh Verma, Raghav Avasthi, Ravi Srivastav continue to be with us, and we are now also joined by Chetan Singh, political analyst here in the studio with me. Good evening to you, Chetan Singh.
Good evening.
You know, people who are saying that she's being hounded, people who are saying that because she's a critic of the NDA government, that's why this move of asking her to submit her CV and the university wanting to rethink or review whether she should continue or not. Is that not an overreaction given the guidelines and the ordinance that the JNU is now citing in its defense?
See, first we need to understand, you know, what is happening from past few years. You know, this is something which has never ever happened. You look at, you know, this lady, especially when it comes down to Romila Thapar, she's an institute by herself. We all are going to agree to it. And also the kind of contribution she has done to the academia is something phenomenal. Second, we have seen that how a MLA of the ruling party comes over there, and MP of a ruling party comes over there, and what he says, Hansraj Hans, he says change the name of JNU and make it.
How is that related to this?
This is because it is politically motivated.
How is that changing of the name related to this?
See, how is it related? Now let me tell you, politically motivation. See, she is a critic of the government, and person like her, whose immense contribution has been acknowledged by the entire globe, and if you're going to treat her like this, this is an indirect political vendetta.
Political vendetta.
See, hold on. You know, in academia,
the government came into power in 2014, and it's not that she was criticizing the government for the past couple of months. So, how is this politically motivated?
Okay, now let me tell you. You see, she is one such lady who has been speaking against the government on various issues. It is not only on any other particular subject. Here, I'm going to say one thing. You know, spineless people, there are few spineless people, they are challenging and questioning the person who is carrying a spine, the person who has taken the flag so high of this country, person who has
Let's question the government, government spokesperson, Sudesh Verma. Also, she was chosen the professor emerita in 1993. Why all of a sudden the JNU now wants to review the situation?
Swati, first of all, I am BJP spokesperson, not speaking on behalf of government. And second, kindly give me some time to put things in perspective, because the debate today is going to nail the lie of these leftists who try to create controversy where there is no controversy. You have already quoted R. Subramaniam, who is the Education Secretary and Minister of HRD. He spoke to the Vice Chancellor, and the Vice Chancellor says there is no move to discontinue the Professor Emeritus status. It's only that he was following an ordinance. What is this ordinance? People should know about it. Your viewers should know about it. Ordinance 32.
What can be expected 32. From the
Please hold on, sir. Note down what I'm saying. Please note down on a paper and then reply.
Sun lije, sir. Ordinance kya hai, sun lije.
Please. Ordinance 32, which is easily available on the website of the JNU, go and find out. It says there, it talks about procedures for appointment of professor emeritus. It also says that those who pass the age of 75 or reach the age of 75, there would be review, and the review would be done by a subcommittee that will be appointed by the executive council. Executive council does the administration of JNU, headed by the vice chancellor. Okay, now the subcommittee has been appointed. Subcommittee issues a notice to Romila Thapar ji saying that aap bataiye aap kya kar rahi hai, because in everywhere across the world, you have to give me early report. Professor emeritus is not something like a Nobel Prize you hang around your head. You have to contribute substantial to the academician. Nobody disputes her contribution.
You're just citing the process.
I'm just citing the process.
Okay.
As a part of the process, a CV has been asked, and also that what she has done about because she is supposed to teach students along with the teacher. And this is the process across the world.
Okay.
What has happened? Instead of giving the CV, you make it a control. Do you know that more than half a dozen people of a far greater status, like Professor Raja Ramanna, I came to know, who is the nuclear scientist. He also enjoys Professor Emeritus status. He has also been issued.
They have been made to go through the same process.
But they don't have
problems. Ravi Srivastava, there are several parameters. Quick word from Ravi
Srivastava.
There are several parameters like age.
Why do you want to change the process?
No, one second, please. Parameters like age, parameters like health, availability. One second. Let me bring in our other panelists also. Ravi Srivastava. So there are several parameters, and it's a guideline based on Ordinance 32 that Sudesh Verma was citing. It's based on parameters like age, parameters like health, parameters like willingness, availability, university needs, etc. So why does this hounding charge come in now?
Yeah, let me tell the latest charge. The latest charge is she was supportive of the five activists who were jailed on the sedition charge just last year.
Who's leveling this charge?
How is this related?
No, who's leveling this charge?
Wait. You have
I am waiting.
Talk about Romila Thapar getting that letter.
Let him finish.
Kluger Award winner, which is next to Nobel Prize. You understand? Because Nobel does not cover all the subjects. So she has been awarded Kluger Award for that. And you are telling that Professor Emerita position is never reviewed in any university.
Who told you that? Princeton University reviews that. Are you aware of anything? Most of the foreign universities, prestigious universities,
we are in India, sir.
Review that.
Sir, do not compare ourselves with any developed
country. Why should you not compare? You want institutes of excellence. And this is a part of JNU.
Come on, sir. Come on,
Professor Emerita is not something.
Raghav Avasthi, the charge is that this is politically motivated. That's why Romila Thapar, an eminent personality, renowned historian and Professor Emeritus, is being asked to submit her CV. All this because this is politically motivated. That's the charge. Now, in its defense, the JNU has said that, you know, she has to respond to our letters and they want to know whether she wants to continue or not based on certain guidelines.
As far as I am concerned, Professor Thapar and her cohorts belong to India's post-colonial self-loathing elite, and that is why if you read all the history books written by her, she has completely glossed over the contributions of our great Hindu kings and dynasties.
Raghav,
I have absolutely no qualms about saying this. I am not going to be politically correct like
that. So you're saying, is that why this has happened? Are you supporting the politically motivated charge, or are you opposing it?
Because Hindu haters should not have any place in
what skills you possess to say these kind of stuff.
Cannot motion such a talk
with personality like this.
Raghav Avasthi went into it. But my question is, Raghav Avasthi, are you saying, is it because of the reasons that you are citing that this has happened?
Of JNU. They are free to do it. But in New India, this is how things will work. If you do have a problem with it, you are free to vote.
So are you saying, that's the reason, behind this reviewing of the status? Ravi Srivastava.
Which New India you are speaking to? There is no New India.
Sir, the rules are old.
Sudesh Verma, you also will have to clarify the position. Do you agree with what Raghav Avasthi is saying?
Can I come in?
No, Raghav Avasthi, one second, please.
What Mr. Raghav is saying is also perception of a section of society. But this is the point which you are making. Your debate is about the rule. The rule of JNU says that.
No, but the entire perception is that. One section says that it is politically motivated.
Swati, and the charge of political hounding will come only when she has been targeted. I am telling you, there are more than half a dozen people who have been issued this notice. Professor Rajendra Banda, nuclear scientist.
Why is JNU under government radar? Why there is so much of focus, so much of attention being given to JNU?
Just because they are issued Romila Thapar, you have a problem. Why?
If you will go through the history of JNU, then how JNU was founded, why Nehru ji wanted to come up.
Relax. Are you also saying that you know this is politically motivated in case of Mr. Raja Ramana also? Why is nobody talking about him? See, why is nobody raising a question that he is also being made to go there through the same process?
See, it's about people reaching 75, whether they want to continue or not.
First and foremost, this lady, Romila Thapar, has contributed so immensely.
And
our boy is this
debate about her contribution.
That is
not.
Debate about her contribution.
Mr. Raja Ramana has not contributed.
That is why she was given emerita. That is why she was given emerita the status. Because she contributed.
The voice is coming from inside. The voice is coming from inside. Now the ripple effect is going to come up.
No. Chetan Singh. You did not agree.
The vice chancellor has done a commendable job.
Okay, one second. You did not agree with Raja Avasthi. You fought his perception. No, you fought his perception.
You say that constitution could not exist for people who are eminent.
Sir, Ravi Srivastava, one second, please. Calm down. Sudesh Verma, one second, please. Okay, calm down. Let me bring in Ravi Srivastava. why are you not questioning these letters being sent to other eminent personalities? Why are you not questioning Mr. Raja Ramana being, you know, being made to go through the same process? Is that not important? Does that, you know, not suit your argument?
I use a strong word. This is a government of illiterates. They should understand that whom are they questioning.
Vice Chancellor is a very, very educated person. All those members of executive council and subcategory members are very educated people.
What are your academic credentials?
There are professors like the JNU with years of experience. You are illiterate.
That's why you are out of power.
Experienced people, knowledgeable people.
Jump that into your cigar and smoke it. You are illiterate and ugly to move.
You are in most of the institutions. This is the biggest challenge. This is the biggest challenge. People are being targeted. If you're going to target people, it's not going to work like this. Absolutely not. And especially at this day, the person who has held the flag high of our country, if the person is going to get targeted like that,
why selectively only talking about Romila Thapar? Why are you only selectively talking about Romila Thapar? There are other individuals also who are being made to go through the same process. Why are you raising their cause? Why are you talking about them? See, why are you not questioning the entire process of sending the letters to others as well?
I agree. See, like, you know, I mean, we need to understand and read between the lines here. The person who has contributed immensely along with that few
more. Again, you know, my question continues. Have others not contributed?
The debate continues.
One section feels it's politically motivated. The other section believes that the guidelines are in place. It was a heated debate, but I have to wrap up. Completely out of time. Thanking all the guests at this point in time. Thank you for watching.